what are your, I wonder if you could kind of move into the world now where kind of like how psychedelics, meditation, floats help to unpack those layers to see that.
Mm-hmm.
And then how do we move through those?
Okay. So what's happening is like, it's a grand illusion that's taking place since the time you're born. You know, people keep telling you things and you start forming your own opinions and you start living in this life where, how I think about it is like, you're an apple tree and I'm a mango tree, but we all try and look like the same bench and we all try and look like the same tree.
Mm.
So what happens is there's a part of you that knows, and this is not agreeing with the part that you're doing consciously. Mm. And this builds up and creates a pressure within you. This is a discomfort you feel when you go do that job and you don't want to do it. And it's the life you live, and then it breaks, right? So when it breaks through extreme suffering, or what happens is in some people's lives, I don't know how it happens, but you get little cues here and there through psychedelics, or people being born into families that meditate. Or you find, like nowadays, there's a huge awakening of meditation and yoga and all these different philosophies and like different techniques for you to see that illusion, just to separate. Once you separate your awareness from who you think you are, that's all it takes.
Mm.
And that's it. People don't have to go through this whole journey of like going into the past and healing yourself. I'm not a fan of that at all.
Mm.
The moment you think about the past and you give it energy, you've given it power to influence your present.
Wow, that's really interesting.
Yeah, so I've always talked about this with my other friends, and they're like, no, but Vijay, you need to heal. I'm like, the moment you use the word heal, you mean something needs to be fixed.
Yes.
But all I have to do is realize that in my journey, if I'm able to think about doing this, then I'm already in the best possible place because I'm aware now. And if I take any experience out from my life, then I won't be here.
Wow. That really just blew my mind, man. That's really good.
Yeah. So you start from here, and now you can build anything, because you can't discount any experience, because the moment you shed light on an experience, that comes from that ego that you've developed at that point in time. Then you're giving it power, and then now it's gonna influence your present and your future again. Yeah. So all you have to do is just notice your awareness and try and separate your awareness from your ego. And it sounds simple, but it's actually very simple. 40 minutes a day. 40
minutes a day.
40 minutes a day. Let your brain waves, because you're biological and people tend to resonate with this idea. Let your brain waves settle, right? As soon as your brain waves settle, you will see there's a slight gap. After 40 minutes, if you can just meditate, it doesn't matter what you do. Just sit there for 40 minutes. And people are like, oh, Vijay, but I can't clear my head. That is not the point of meditation.
Mm.
Right? You can't. If you can have a clear head for 5 minutes, you'll enlighten yourself. That's how hard it is.
Mm.
So just create that separation. And as soon as you feel that gap, enjoy it. You don't want to do anything else. Just live your day and slowly start opening that gap. And that's what I do with my programs as well. And once you open that gap and you can go to that awareness at will, that's it. You can't suffer anymore.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah.